Le processus classificatoire est universel et il est impliqué dans tout type de connaissances.
Is universal and always involved in all kinds of knowledge. An object has a meaning when it's classified in a reference system. Every society, every social group within society puts its environment in order, and this applies to nature. So next to the scientific classification, there are popular classifications. The scientific classification was instituted by Carl von Linné, a naturalist. He divided nature in main categories, from the kingdom to the species, and he set up the binomial denomination, genera, species, and he was the author who described them for the first time. So why a scientific classification? Because plants and animals may have different denominations. In France, Quercus robur, the white oak, has two common names and three regional or local denominations. In Namibia, Acacia aureoloba has up to 13 denominations, three from the Kolon languages, German, English, and Afrikaner, and 10 local denominations coming from 7 local languages. Therefore, we have a hierarchical framework, universal and exhaustive, where each species corresponds to a single name. Popular classification is at the heart of ethnoscience. Ethnoscience is based on the knowledge of nature held by local populations. If we were to remember a few authors at the origin of ethnoscience, we could mention Durkheim and Morse. In their article on a few primitive forms of classification, showed that Northern American Indians, Native Indians, and Aborigines in Australia divide their environment in large categories, including clans, but also animals, plants, artifacts, or natural phenomena. Conklin in 54 claims to be the first one to have conducted the research on ecoscience, and he evidenced the existence of vernacular classification in the Filipino populations. Hanuno, Levi-Strauss and the Wild Thought underlines the importance of the science of concrete and the quality of biological and behavioral knowledge on plants and animals held by indigenous populations, also including natural phenomena. In order to study vernacular classification, we have to move away from the subjectivity linked with the observer's culture to try and understand the way the society sees its own environment and divides its own environment. So we have to integrate the indigenous vision of the world. We have to know the language spoken by the society being studied in order to understand and list the local taxonomy and understand the real nature of the society being studied. The classification process is based on three operations which are not necessarily taking place at the same time, can be used in different orders and depend on the local, cultural, and social environmental culture context. Identification, denomination, and insertion in the reference system with the categories. Let's come back to the comparison between scientific classification and popular classification. We may see that there doesn't always seem to be a correspondence between the two. And for organizational purposes, if there is hierarchy in the scientific classification, each element can only be in a given place. This is not true for popular classification. I'll give you an example. A3 will be present in a category A, but also another D category next to different taxons such as B and C. In the popular classification, some elements will not be categorized and will remain outside of any whole category such as X. I'll give you a few examples now. In the Aka pygmy population in Central Africa, there are some very interesting elements regarding vernacular classification. Scientifically speaking, butterfly and caterpillar are classified the same way and belong to the same genera and species, Imbrasa oyamensis here. But for Aka pygmies, they have two different classifications, Kogongo and Mboyo. But interestingly, there are different denominations for caterpillars, whereas all butterflies will be called Kogongo. This is an interesting comparison with the scientific classification. Pygmy discriminate butterflies from caterpillars. And Aka pygmy categorize and integrate in the same category all of the comestible caterpillars, and they are all called Congo. Again, Aka pygmies classify these three animals, a bat, a bird, and a flying squirrel, differently. Scientifically, the animals will be divided between birds and mammals, and three orders for birds, columbiforms or galliforms, for bats, chiroptères, and for the squirrel rodents. But for acapygmies, these three animals belong to the same category, Neodidae, flying vertebrates, which can also be eaten. They are edible for acapygmies. Now, we'll take a more northern country example, the down eider duck. For this species, we have a single denomination, Somateria mollissima. This is the only scientific denomination, and a more overall category for Inuit populations meeting. The female is brown and the male is black and white, but for the Inuit, there are three denominations for the female, depending on sexual maturity, and four denominations for the adult male, depending also on the feathers, and seven denominations for the duckling, when it hatches out of the egg, to the stage when it almost reaches sexual maturity, and it's called Enmetyravini. This example is very interesting because it illustrates the difference between the vernacular science and up to 50 taxons for the vernacular classification. The study of scientific classification and vernacular classification is important because it shows that each society has its own vision of the world, identifies elements constituting its world, giving them a name and inserting them in categories. Each society and each social group therefore has its own representation of the world. One side of the scientific, next to the scientific classification, there is a diversity of denominations in nature.